So, as many of you have probably heard by now, there was a shooting that took place in Colorado Springs, Colorado. Now, what makes this really interesting is the fact that this crime was perpetrated by a white Christian male, something that we've actually seen time and time again over the last year happening in many parts of the country. There's been many of these shootings that have happened, particularly incidents like the Charleston shooting, church shooting that took place, in which Dylan Roof, a white supremacist young adult, took the lives of 9 churchgoers. And much like also the fact that John Russell Hauser, who 57, who took the lives of at least, I believe it was like 5 women or something like that in Louisiana, who also was a white supremacist and a Christian fundamentalist. In both these cases, these men had ties to white supremacist organizations, Dylan Roof being with Stormfront, John Russell Hauser being tied to the New York chapter of Greece's Golden Dawn Party. And currently, this is one of those situations where we have to examine what this person, what this person stood for, who he might have been connected with. Now, the name of the Colorado Springs shooter has been identified as Robert Lewis Deere. And this man is the same age as John Russell Hauser is, 57. And while it cannot really be confirmed or denied, although there are some reports that say that this is not a true statement, it was alleged that, according to NBC News, that Deere shouted "no more baby parts" as he shot up Planned Parenthood in Colorado Springs. Citing 2 law enforcement sources, the network reported Deere's ramblings were so disjointed that it wasn't clear whether the mention of baby parts was enough to establish a concrete motive. Deere is a North Carolina native, also mentioned President Obama while being grilled by police. Sources have also said that there was no evidence of a diagnosed mental health issue or felony conviction, meaning that Deere was free to legally purchase the rifle he used in the shooting on Friday. Now, of course, this will bring up a lot of issues regarding gun control and gun violence, and none of that is really that relevant when you consider that this is that the people that tend to go after gun violence and gun control, savvy people, typically tend to be the very reactionary, neoliberal, individuals and stuff like that. Typically white liberals who try to really distance themselves and react to what I would consider appeals to emotion. And the problem is that this is a perfect example. This shooting is a perfect example of people that have all legal means to get a gun and still can commit acts of violence. You can't get rid of guns. People will find a way to get guns, even if they have to go through the black market. People will continue to have guns. Guns will continue to exist, as well as the fact that guns, they're just a fact of life. Shootings are going to happen. We can prevent them. We can even decrease the number of them. But we prevent and actually have stopped hundreds, thousands of attacks every single day this year, every year, trying to stop incidents like the Paris attacks and stop things like Colorado Springs and Charleston. We've stopped so many of similar situations that could have gone on, but we don't hear about that. Instead, people only focus on the negative, and they always try to pin the problem on guns. Guns are not the problem. It's crazy assholes like, John Russell Hauser and Robert Deere and Dylan Roof. It's white supremacists and religious fundamentalists that are the problem. it's this fanaticism, this political and religious extremism that is the biggest problem. It's not guns. It can be an issue with mental health, yes, but it's not fucking guns. And people need to quit harping on that whole idealism. So it's one of those things that I always try to purport that whole, you know, propagate that whole issue, and people just, you know, tend to seem to ignore it. But it is the fact that that this man did go in there. He shot up a bunch of people, injured at least 9 people, I believe it was, and killed 3 other people. Now, what I think is really most interesting about this, I mean, it is clear cut that that Robert Louis Deer is most likely a very right-wing leaning pro-life conservative, you know, and religious fundamentalist. What really gets me is the fact that a lot of other pro-lifers, a lot of pro-life activists, and a lot of religious right-wing extremists have been coming out and actually supporting what this man did. Yes, there are actually people that have actually called this man a hero. Think about that for a second. People that claim to be pro-life, you know, that are so up in arms about, you know, people having abortions and about Planned Parenthood, you know, spying and selling baby parts, which, by the way, has been disproven several fucking times. It's the fact that these people who go out there and are harping on abortion and are claiming to be pro-life, yet when something like this happens at a Planned Parenthood, no less, that suddenly these people in their hypocritical and narrow-minded views support a person that shot and killed 3 people. So apparently the fetus that you're claiming to protect is so much more important than 3 lives. So somehow the lives of these people that died don't matter because they happen to be in that facility, or they happen to be workers of that facility. Suddenly their lives don't matter. That's very pro-life. That's very fucking Christian of you. That doesn't seem to bring about some level of hypocrisy, that you claim to be pro-life yet support the killing of 3 people and the maiming of at least 9 other individuals. No, the shooting of a dozen people apparently doesn't mean anything to you. It just doesn't, does it? But you don't see the tremendous level of hypocrisy in that? If you're going to be pro-life, then be pro-life. Don't be a fucking hypocritical bigot. Because what this man did, how is this any different than the Paris attacks? Because that's what exactly this is. What occurred in Colorado Springs at Planned Parenthood was nothing more than a terrorist act by a white Christian terrorist. It's white religious extremism. How is that different from the atrocities that were committed by the hands of so-called Islamic fundamentalists? But how is that different from the quasi-fascist attacks that have happened in Paris? It's not. And the people that are outright fucking supporting this man are no different than an ISIL terrorist. They're no different. It is absolutely there's no difference at all. Now, of course, I do want to bring up one important thing here before I continue on my rant. There are, much like many Muslims around the world that condemn the Paris attacks many Arabs around the world that condemn the Paris attacks. There are Christians that have condemned the Colorado Springs attack. There has been Christians that are very pro-life that have condemned this man's actions, that have condemned the attacks, because these people, even though they are pro-life, and although I may not agree with them, they at least have the morals, yes, the morals, to admit that what was done was wrong. Because they know that being a pro-lifer means being pro-life. It does not mean you get to pick and choose what lives matter and what lives don't. These people understand that. And I give, and though I may not agree with their views, I give them a tremendous amount of respect for that, for recognizing that, for propagating that. Because at least they're not the simple-minded assholes that basically are just, you know, that are, you know, only out there for, because they're protesting anti-abortion issues and, you know, protesting this abortion thing, but they're not out there, you know, supporting what this man did. You know, at least they have the sack to be, to have that moral to them, to not be a hypocrite. Even people like Mike Huckabee, of all fucking people, even has condemned this as an act of domestic terrorism. Yes, Mike Huckabee has even declared this terrorism. And you know what? I agree with him. For once on this, I will agree with Mike Huckabee. This was an act of domestic terrorism. What was committed was a crime against humanity. And there, in more, we'll humor the Christians for a second. It was a crime against God. It was a crime against people. And the fact that people are, that there are still some people out there that are trying to rationalize and liberate and, you know, they're trying to make this man out to be some sort of hero for them. These are people that are just absolutely insane. They, like I said, they are no different than ISIL terrorists. And I think that in this case, Mike Huckabee would probably agree. These people are no different than what happened in Paris. What has been done was not necessary. Just because you disagree with Planned Parenthood and, you know, what you believe that they do, doesn't mean a damn thing. What this man did was kill innocent lives and trying to take other innocent lives with it. And to support something like that and call someone a hero for doing that would be like some Muslim, you know, jumping up and saying, yeah, what the attacks that happened in Paris were justified because reasons. Do you kind of see what I'm trying to get at here? Do you see how controversial and just assholish that would sound? Then maybe you can kind of get an inkling on what you sound like when you support a shooter, when you support a person that took the lives of three people. I just don't understand those individuals. And this also goes to show the level of absurdity that some Americans have resorted to. This shows the absolute level of petty fascism that this country is headed to. And then you wonder why people like Donald Trump and Ben Carson and even Ted Cruz are leading in Republican polls. Like, seriously? That shows you the tremendous level of hypocrisy, irony, and just level of idiocy that the right wing has become. That the right wing in America has become. It also shows the tremendous the tremendous level of just sheer evil that that Christian fundamentalism has become. It really does say a lot when Christians that are right-wing, Christians that are very pro-life, are coming out and actually saying that what was done was wrong, and saying that anybody that's supporting these actions are not Christian, and they're not, that they don't represent their movement. And they're right. That's one thing that we should definitely keep in mind here. These people don't represent the entire pro-life movement. They don't. But it definitely does not help their movement in the slightest by trying to say that Deer was a hero. It doesn't help them at all. You know, And be quite frank, it doesn't represent Christianity. I'm pretty sure that Jesus would not have supported, you know, the shooting of three people. It's like, okay, you don't agree with the idea of abortion, but you're going to support the deaths of three people and the maiming of nine? You don't think that your Jesus would have condemned that? It's people like this, it's those particular people that have completely lost their faith, or are on their way to losing their faith, because they have clenched so hard to that Bible, which I'm pretty sure they haven't really, you know, looked into that often. And it's just absolutely insane that they don't seem to get it. So, basically, it's one of these things where we really just need to focus on the issues at hand here. Now, of course, let me at least go back to the of this whole idea of the people that are calling this man a hero. Tweets have been released by Pathios, and with certain names like @VampyKiss, Planned Parenthood people want police to save their lives. Strange they don't give a shit about babies' lives. Planned Parenthood shooter has done more in one day to save black babies than Black Lives Matter has done in the last several months. I'll get to that in a minute. That one was by @BrianWarner775. This one @DejaXSun says, I wonder how many unborn babies were saved by this gunman interrupting normal Planned Parenthood activities. Just looking on the bright side. First of all, grammatical error. It's saved, not save. Gonna be a grammar idiot for a minute. But yeah, these are people that were praising the Planned Parenthood shooter. Now, one of the things I want to get at is the people that are that are basically talking about the Planned Parenthood want police to save their lives, but Planned Parenthood has done more in one day to save black babies' lives and stuff like that. I find there's a level of irony to the All Lives Matter movement, which is, you know, a reaction from, you know, from white reactionaries, specifically at the hands of Christian fundamentals and other things like that. I think it's quite hilarious that people claim to be All Lives Matter in the United States when it concerns, you know, the Black Lives Matter, Police Lives Matter. They're just like, well, all lives matter. Why are we fighting over this issue? All lives matter. And we've been talking about how, yes, we're focusing on the black lives and stuff like that. I find it funny that people are talking about who go hopping on this All Lives Matter, but when suddenly we start talking about immigrants, or we start talking about the refugees from Syria, or talking about, you know, the lives of three people that were mercilessly killed in Colorado Springs, suddenly the All Lives Matter movement doesn't become All Lives Matter. It's just selective lives that matter. You know, which is another tremendous amount of hypocrisy. Again, if you're going to be pro-life and you're going to be all lives matter, should you not then be supporting all lives being pro-life? You know, supporting the lives of even those that the person fucking killed? You know, should you not be supporting the lives of Syrian refugees who are trying to escape their war zones, or trying to support people that have literally nothing in their countries and are trying to come here for a better life, or to other countries for a better life? Suddenly then all lives don't matter to you all of a sudden? Then you need to stop being an all lives matter person. You need to quit being a pro-lifer, because you're not all lives matter. You're not pro-life. You're a fucking dickhead is what you are. In fact, even it's claimed to be pro-life and supporting the deaths of three people, or, you know, not wanting to support immigrants, or, you know, at least, you know, or supporting refugees coming here, you're not pro-life. You're a complete hypocrite. And if anything, with you know, celebrating the deaths of three people because you don't support abortion, that just makes you an anti-abortionist prick. It doesn't make you a pro-lifer. Because again, how can you support life but basically not care about three people that were murdered? Again, there's a tremendous level of hypocrisy. How can you support the life of a fetus when you don't even support your homeless veteran that's basically asking for spare change, you know, every day, and you just basically call them a low-life bum who needs to get a job? How can you call yourself pro-life then? You know, you're so pro-life when the fetus is in the womb, but as soon as it comes out of the womb, you're yelling at the mother, saying that she's a deadbeat mother, that she's a bad mother, saying that, you know, once the fetus gets old enough that it's a deadbeat that needs to get a job, that, you know, you'll support it if that fetus goes off into the military. But once that child comes back to the, you know, comes back and is a civilian again and has nothing and is left to basically, you know, become homeless, you don't support them then. You just think that they're a low-life bum that needs to get a job. Yeah, that's very pro-life. That's very Christian of you. So again, tremendous level of hypocrisy that comes from the right-wing extremists, from the Christian fundamentalist group of individuals. So that's why again, I absolutely do respect the people that, even if they don't agree with what Planned Parenthood stands for to them, that they at least have the capacity for sympathy, the capacity for morality, and at least the capacity for intellect, where they at least realize that there's a difference between being pro-life and just being, you know, a complete asshole who doesn't give a fuck. They know that there's a difference between being pro-life and anti-abortion. They know that there's a time that you should be against Planned Parenthood's actions, and when you need to stand with them in solidarity because individual lives got killed. The fact that it's Planned Parenthood shouldn't even be relevant. The fact that these were lives that were taken, lives that were maimed, that's what should matter. That's what should really matter. But for some people, it doesn't. And those are the people that really need to get a grip on their priorities, their morality, and frankly, need to get a grip on reality. Because what they're doing and stuff like that is very unchristian. It's very, you know, it's anti-life. It's not pro-life. And frankly, it's hypocritical. So that's the thing I want to point out in this video. That's what I really wanted to talk about, was this tremendous level of hypocrisy, this tremendous level of just outright quasi-fascism, and some with outright fascism. This outright just support for hatred and support for violence. You know, that's sort of shit we did in the Dark Ages. That's shit that the Nazis tried to bring about and did bring about for 12 years. That's not who we are as a people anymore. That should not be how we are as a people. This should not represent Christianity. This should not represent the pro-life movement. And this should not represent Americans. This should not represent any human being. But there are people that are trying to make that so. And those are the people that are dangerous. Those are the people that really need to be institutionalized. Because those are the people that are causing the rifts in America. They're causing the rifts in our societies. And so, in a closing argument, while I am pro-choice, while I stand for women's rights, while I stand for a lot of different things, you know, and while I may be an outright ardent Marxist, the fact is I do have to stand in and defend the real pro-lifers at this moment. I really have to stand in and defend the Planned Parenthood movement, and I really have to stand in and to sympathize and defend the lives of those that were killed and maimed. I have to acknowledge the fact that there are a lot of different factors in this shooting than a lot of the ordinary acts of violence that we've seen in the last year, because this is a very complicated case. It is important to note that, again, not all pro-lifers think the way these extremists do, that not all pro-lifers are this moronic, that there are actually some with intellectual, moral, and, you know, realistic ideals. While I may not agree with the pro-life movement in any way, at least they actually, today, have earned the ones that actually are standing and condemning this attack, at least I can give them some respect in that matter. And I do. It's one of those things where it's very hard for me, it's very humbling for me to have to make a stand on that, to even say that I actually agree with a statement made by Mike Huckabee. It's very humbling. It's a very bitter pill to swallow, but I can't just outright go out and say, well, all Christians think this way, that all right-wingers think this way, and they don't. I may make fun of right-wing policy. I may make fun of Christian religious ideals. I may outright be blatantly hard on them. But there does come a time such as this where there is a need to really differentiate the issues that go on within that. I've said it before and I will say it again here. The Christian right, much like much of the right wing, is very fractured. It's very broken. There's a lot of different factions within it. And this right here is a prime example of that. This is all going on in America, but it is not limited to America. Right-wingism itself throughout the world is very fractured. Ideologies are very fractured themselves. And I think that we are going to see more of these sorts of factions and fracturings and stuff like that play out. And does that also mean that there may be an increased level of violence from these people? Probably. But we cannot let reactionism dictate our actions. We cannot let hatred and blind bigotry control us. In the words of Master Yoda, fear leads to anger. Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering. I'm NorCal Nick, leader of the revolutionist movement, and this has been NorCal Corner. Peace.
You never really can fix my heart.